here with Pastor Glenn Wilson. Glenn, you grew up here in Cuba and moved to the United States. And then 30 years later, you came back to your native country, your native city of Caimanera. What effect do you see this Corban baseball team having here in Caimanera?
Well, it's been really amazing. As we've been saying the whole way, that this has been a historical event to actually have Americans in this territory. I never thought I'd see the day when the officials would allow Americans to come into this territory so close to the American base. Certainly this is a God thing, and Corban University has initiated has opened a door that I believe is going to impact the world.
So what sorts of lasting effects do you see that could really come from this trip, not only here in Caimanera, but in Cuba?
Well, you have given the Cuban people a chance to rub shoulders with Americans. Over 60 years of history, there has not been an American on these soils. And what we saw yesterday in those games, Americans for the first time rubbing shoulders with Cubans, and Cubans having a desire to rub shoulders with you, that's historical. And I believe that's not just going to stay here. That's going to impact the whole nation. And I believe that it is beginning a trend that is going to bring real changes, lasting changes to this nation. But I believe that the greatest change is taking place in us, because we never thought God could use us to do something like this. This is a historical moment.
Here with Darren Milionis. Darren, what sort of impact have you seen this Corban baseball team make here in the city of Caimanera?
Well, the first thing that comes to mind is that I think the people here had an impression of the United States that we were evil. And I think they now have a different perception. I think barriers have been broke down. The stereotype of the United States has been changed in their minds. The other thing that I believe has taken place is that if they knew a little bit about Christianity, they now know just a little bit more. They see it in action. They see the players praying before a game. They've heard us say that we are praying for their injured player. So I think Christianity is now a little more evident as to what it's about. We've surpassed the expectations of Pastor Glenn specifically, as he has mentioned that we've given these people hope. Their lifestyle, they don't have anything to look forward to, he's mentioned. Something like outsiders coming in and there being a game here is something that they don't know. And as we observe, the kids themselves have been so enthusiastic, and I think that's encouraged our players to see that God can use them in part of his plan to bring hope and salvation to these kids. So I think they're seeing God in action using them.
We're here with Jay Velez. Jay, what an incredible trip it has been. Part of Corban's mission statement says to make a difference in the world for Jesus Christ. How would you say, only having been with this Corban baseball team for just a few days now, how would you say that the Warriors are making a difference in the world for Jesus Christ?
Well, I think the team has done a big difference in using their simple natural talents and spiritual gifts to just use them in a baseball field. Their character, their love, their passion, their abilities, their temperaments, and just using it on the baseball field and letting God use that ability to bridge a gap of misunderstanding between two nations and whatever stigmas culture has raised upon both countries about how each other country is. And I see them, that they've used their simple giftings just to make a big difference and impact on the baseball diamond, from learning the basic foundations and fundamentals of baseball, executing them on the field, their practice, their habits of practicing baseball and all that stuff, all those things were used and gave a message. Just them by living what they've been learning all along from their home to school, college, and what they've learned every day. It's made a big impact, and it's made their life message has been shared and communicated without having to say, "Thus saith the Lord."
So there have been some historical differences between both the United States and Cuba. How would you say the Corban baseball team, just being here in Caimanera, how would you say that they're helping to bridge some of those gaps?
Well, baseball is like a universal language, a sport, you know, it's a passion here in Cuba. It's always been a passion. And it was here before the revolution. It's here during the revolution, after the revolution, and it's part of the culture here. And it's part of our culture in America, baseball, you know, baseball, apple pie, and Chevrolet. it's definitely bridged the gap because it's a common language. So even though our students, majority don't speak Spanish, and over here the majority don't speak English, baseball is a common language, and we're rooting from each other, we understand each other. And the body language has just united us, and we've been able to bridge and break whatever strongholds and stigmas that each country might have of each other, and humanly, we've just communicated the love of God and the love of Christ through all that. It's just broken those barriers, and baseball has just made us forget our differences and see how much we do have in common.
Jeff, what an amazing week it was in Cuba. If you could sum up the trip in one sentence, what would that be?
Well, it was beyond anything that I expected, and it was a situation where I think it was what I would call a God thing. I think God was working through us.
So why would you say that?
I just felt the uniqueness of the event, the historic part of the event, that city being the way that it reached out to us, the way that we reached out to them, us representing God, but also representing our country, and they representing themselves in a sense on an individual basis. And for the two to come together in love and respect, I think was a God-inspired.
So what would you say the type of impact you think that the trip had on your players?
I think it had a huge impact on them. I think the impact is actually going to be felt even more over time. I don't know that they ever thought that they would be that accepted there, that the Cuban people would be that loving. And I think they saw the power of God. And obviously when you see that, that's going to change everything.